Well, hello, I'm back again. This is your brother, your friend, Prophet Wes, again. And those that know me by now, you know that I'm pretty direct, and I don't want to waste words. God dropped a word in my spirit, and this is the direct word here. And God says that the hurt has helped. The hurt has helped. How you got hurt, the situation that hurt you. See, because the thing about it, if you look at it, picture this, let me explain. When you're in school, what you have is a classroom, and then you have a teacher. And what happens that each period, the teacher teaches a lesson, you know, a subject. And so picture, hurt has been the teacher, that situation, and you being the one, the student, who learned the lesson. And so, you know, one of the things that I think I've talked about it before about, you know, learning the game, when the game is being played on you. And the thing about it, when someone plays a game on you, just naturally, so what happens if you're studious and if you pay attention, then what you'll do, you'll learn the game. Just like when you're playing a game, whatever it is, basketball, baseball, football, whatever it is, you may lose, but if you study your opponent's patterns, if you study your opponent's tendencies, weaknesses, and strengths, then what will happen, you will learn their strengths and you'll learn the game. And so you'll learn the game. And so that's why I says that God revealed it to me, and he was talking to me to speak to you, to say, let you know that the hurt has really helped you. Because the hurt served as a teaching moment, and inside of that hurt, God has been talking to you. He's been giving you understanding. You've been going through a whole lot of stuff. You've been going through many changes, many rejections, ups and downs, all that. Uncomfortable. Many of you are uncomfortable. But through all of that, God has been teaching you. See, but think about it. What makes anything grow is from being uncomfortable. That's how a mother has a baby, because that mother is uncomfortable. And the more uncomfortable that mother is, the closer that baby is coming. And so at the place of being uncomfortable, that's the place of your deliverance, the place of uncomfortable, being uncomfortable. Because that uncomfortable place is a platform that will cause your deliverance to be released. So the hurt has helped you. It has. So just go back and just thank God for the victory and how he's giving you the information and how he's giving you the strength to be able to come through it. He's giving you the grace. He said his grace is sufficient. So in other words, God has already, and whatever test that you've been through, he's already given you the strength. He's already given you the understanding. He's already given you the ability to come through it, to withstand it. And so that's why many of you, you're in a situation where it feels like it's overwhelming. Well, if you're in a situation where it's overwhelming, soon God is going to send your release. He's going to send your escape. He's going to bring your deliverance. See, because the Bible says that God will never put more on us than we're able to bear. But with the temptation, he will provide a way of escape. So the hurt has helped you, because the hurt has taught you strength. It's taught you determination. It's taught you independence. It's taught you even more faith, because you've been tossed so much, you've been hurt so much, and that you had to rely and lean on God. And at the place of leaning on God, God has been there to help you. He's been there also. That hurt also served as information. That hurt also served as revelation knowledge. There was things that was revealed. And see, in pain and in trouble and pressure, God reveals himself. Case in point, the three Hebrew boys, when they were in the fiery furnace, there was someone else in there that was likened unto the Son of Man. So Jesus, God revealed himself. He revealed himself in the pressure, and he revealed himself in the pain. And so God is teaching. It's teaching. It's a teaching moment. It's every time you go through rejection, every time you go through disappointment, And you don't want to think about it. You want to think about it, but it is, it really is a teaching moment. Because, and so what I try to do when I'm going through something, as bad as it, I try to shake myself and I try to be still for a moment and think and say, well, what is it that you're trying to teach me, God? What information that you're trying to give me? What level of elevation that you're trying to take me to and take me through? And so that's how I assess when troubles come, when pains come. And so the hurt is help. It's really helping. It's helping because also it's causing you to appreciate God more. It's also calling you to appreciate every day. It's calling you to appreciate what you have. See, also sometimes what happens when you don't have something for a long time, but then when you get it, you appreciate having it, especially when you didn't had it for a long time. And so what's happening, God is bringing appreciation. The hurt has brought appreciation. The hurt has brought a greater measure of respect. The hurt has brought more love. It's like an eye-opening experience. It's eye-opening where you understand a lot more when you go through hurt. Also, wisdom comes through hurt. Solomon bears us out because Solomon said, in wisdom, there's much sorrow. And to get knowledge, you're going to go through a whole lot of grief. And so in order to get certain things, there's certain things that you had to go through. You had to suffer. But in that suffering also, there's an elevation. There's a relationship there when you suffer. It's called the fellowship of his suffering. So in other words, every blow, every hurt, every disappointment, every rejection, you're being closer to God. You're getting closer. And also his face is being revealed. His face more being revealed. The fellowship of his suffering, the more you suffer, the more his face in your situation is being revealed. His face, his power, his plan of attack is being revealed in your pressure. In your pressure, that's the revelation knowledge. His face is being revealed. In your pressure, his power is being revealed. In your pressure, his understanding, direction, the blueprint on your purpose, the blueprint on his plan concerning your life is in your pressure. And so the hurt has helped because the hurt is the blueprint. The hurt has given you a blueprint to be able to study, to be able to see, to be able to observe. The Bible tells us to watch. And in watching, you got to observe as well as pray. Got to go. But the hurt, it really has helped you. God bless you.